Welcome back to the Daily Mastermind. George Wright III here with your daily dose of inspiration, motivation, and education. I hope your week is off to a good one. I'm looking forward to really going through a lot of things with you this week, and I hope that you'll give me some feedback. One of the things I'd like to ask you to do is if you're enjoying or benefiting from the topics that we cover, that you send us some feedback and let us know how you're doing and what we can do to tailor the content that we have on the show with our interviews and with articles and blogs to help you with your life, to create your best life. So later this week on the Mastermind, we're going to be covering, on Tuesday, we'll have Robert Stuberg's Lifetime Success Process. On Wednesday, we've got some great stuff for motivation and inspiration midweek. And then on Thursday, we'll have one of our Prosperity Report interviews with a seven-figure mentor. I think you're really going to like this one. And on Friday, we've got some lifestyle type things, but I also have an article that I'd like to share with you that I've read recently. So that's what's coming up on the Mastermind. Today, the quote of the day in the Daily Mastermind mobile app is from Zig Ziglar. And the quote is, do you respond to life or do you react to life? And do you know the difference, I guess, is the way I would put it. Do you respond to life or do you react to life? That's such a great quote because I think a lot of times we are just reacting to things that happen to us rather than responding in a productive way. So today we're beginning our series. Every Monday we'll be covering prosperity pillars. And for those of you that have not seen the pillars before, you know, over the last 20, 25 years, I've had the opportunity to work with some of the greatest minds, thought leaders, business owners, and individuals in the marketplace in all kinds of different areas. And that's why I sort of pulled together what I felt were 12 of the most important concepts in success, personal development, business. And they are these prosperity pillars. And for those of you that don't have the poster or haven't looked at the pillars, I'm going to read them to you real quick. It starts with, I create my life. I take personal responsibility. I act in spite of my mood. I surround myself with positive people. I focus on results. I'm sorry, I focus on solutions. I go from memory. Sometimes I'm focused on results myself. I focus on solutions. I create an attitude of abundance. I choose to be happy. I always think win-win. I am committed to lifelong learning. I create daily rituals, I attract success, and I visualize and manifest my life. Those are the 12 prosperity pillars, and today we're going to be talking about the first one, I create my life. Now, this is the pillar that begins all of the process that that I focus on in my life, and it's one that you deal with every day. You're always struggling to take this perspective, but Jim Rohn said, we all have two choices. We can either make a living or we can design a life. Which one are you doing right now? Are you just making a living or are you designing your life? We begin all of our activities and life and results as a, you know, that we achieve from our thoughts. You know, we always talk about our thoughts create our life, right? Well, if our thoughts create our life, then and we want to be able to create our life, then we have to focus on directing our thoughts. We have to focus on putting our thoughts and focusing them on the right things. So tomorrow we're going to go through this lifetime success process that Robert Stuberg has come up with. It's sort of seven steps to creating your best life. But the very first step is the secret. And that is, the secret is, you know, if you don't already know this by now, that your thoughts do create your life. So in order to really believe and apply this concept and this first prosperity principle of I create my life, you have to remind yourself that you can and must put effort into planning, directing, and executing on a designed plan for the life that you want to live. You have to remember this formula, right? I've talked about it before. Your thoughts are going to create feelings, and those feelings will drive your actions, and that is what's going to create your results. And once you know that, you have to begin to create and direct your thoughts, your activities, your actions, everything inside your day-to-day routine so that your life will unfold in the way you want it to unfold rather than in response or reaction to everything around you. So let me give you just a few ideas, steps, things that you can do in order to start getting your thinking focused in the right way. First, you have to believe that you can create your life. Belief is going to come, yes, in part from your experiences, but you have to just make the choice to believe that all of us are capable of great things. All of us can push much further than that 40% mark that David Goggins talks about, where most people stop. So in order to believe you can, sometimes it's just a choice, and you have to choose to operate outside your comfort zone of what you feel you're capable of. Second, you need to start to get your daily routine in check, because your daily routine are the activities and rituals and learning and focus that you do every day, and that will direct your energy towards the right thoughts, the right things. So having a daily routine and having consistent, committed discipline towards that routine. Now remember, I talked to you about find activities that work for you. Not everybody should, you know, meditate or journal or, you know, visualize it. You need to do what works best for you to get your day started and to close out your day. Third, got to come back to the goals and the clarity of vision, because you can't hit a destination unless you actually have a direction that you're going. So start with something. Don't be too concerned about what it's going to look like, but start to crystallize your vision so that you can begin to build a map towards where you want to be. So set some goals. Set some big goals. Don't hold back. And then number four, create a scorecard. Now, we haven't talked a lot about this, but you hear me mention that you have to be able to record, track, evaluate, and adjust the direction and trajectory of your life. And if you don't have an actual scorecard you look at, this goes for your budget, this goes for your life, this goes for your relationships. If you're not measuring the success you're having, then you won't increase and do better and learn and grow. So that's so important to have a scorecard. And then fifth, have a mentor. Join a mastermind group. You know, sometimes it's difficult. Let me put it this way. I think you would agree with the fact that the mindset that's gotten you where you are is probably not the mindset that's going to get you to further down the road. It might be giving you good habits and techniques, but sometimes we can't see ourselves as well as someone else can help see us. But what's important here is for you to find the right kind of people. You don't want people that will put up with excuses, or that will tell you what you want to hear, or that will be around you just supporting you but not helping you to grow. That's why a mentor or a mastermind group or individuals that can help you, that will be objective and tell you what you need to hear, are the most important thing. People that have done what you want to do or that are where in life you want to be. That's the reason I bring that up, because we all need to find good support to take us to the next level in our life. So it's my goal here with the Daily Mastermind, as well as my partner Robert, to help you keep focused and driven towards creating your best life. So I hope these ideas today will be a good step to get your week started. It'll be something that'll help you to start focusing throughout the week on creating your life. And then join me tomorrow and I'll walk you through the lifetime success process that Robert has developed over the decades of experience. And he's created results for thousands of high-end clients. And we'll get you started on that process as well. Thanks for listening. Go subscribe to this podcast and share it with a friend. Do us a favor, and it'll mean the world to me. Share it with somebody that you know, and that'll help you to be able to embed these principles as well. When you teach things, you learn things. Have a great day. Once again, this is George Wright III, and this has been the Daily Mastermind. Talk to you tomorrow.